In the past decade, a recent trend has seen worries grow about the increased use of technology and how it impacts the human body, from mental issues to physical ones. Aside from its effect on posture, one of technology's most glaring issues from society's perspective is that of eye strain. It isn't unreasonable to think that increased screen time, especially in poorly lit environments, would negatively impact one's eyesight. Many claim that blue light, a slice of the visible light spectrum emitted from digital screens, hurts their eyes and can cause lasting negative effects. This concern has given rise to a huge market for blue light blocking, or just blue light glasses. As the name suggests, these block the blue light coming from your screen and therefore reduce blue light's effect on your eyes. But there's a big problem here. Blue light doesn't actually hurt your eyes. At least most studies haven't found any conclusive data to support the use of blue light glasses. It's not hard to find scientists shying away from these glasses either, especially with the American Academy of Ophthalmology reporting that it's not necessary to spend money on special eyewear for computer use. These conclusions make sense too when you look into the science. For example, the amount of blue light emitted by screens is tiny compared to the amount we're exposed to from the sun every day. So if we're constantly exposed to blue light from the sun, a smaller amount emitted from our screens wouldn't really affect us. That being said, studies have shown that blue light does impact our circadian rhythm by suppressing melatonin production levels, therefore making it harder to sleep. But again, this makes sense. Is it harder to fall asleep in broad daylight or in the dark? So if a screen is lighting up your face, it will make it harder to sleep because our bodies are meant to be awake and aware during the light hours of the day. However, there's still one piece of information that stands against this. People who use blue light glasses usually claim that they help them sleep better, and this extends beyond anecdotal stories. A 2017 study from the University of Houston found that participants wearing the glasses showed about a 58% increase in their nighttime melatonin levels, which helped them sleep better. So how does this fit into the American Academy of Ophthalmology and even the UK's Association of Optometrists saying that the blue light glasses aren't necessary? Well, there are two reasons that explain the general scientific attitude towards blue light glasses. Firstly, there hasn't been a lot of evidence to support the fact that blocking blue light helps sleep. This is either because too few studies have been conducted to confirm that, or because other factors are seen to be more detrimental to one's eyes than blue light. An example of this is that the University of Manchester published a study that shows that yellow light disrupts sleep patterns in mice more than blue light. Again, this study hasn't been conducted with humans, nor does it say that blue light has no impact on one's eyes. The second reason for this general scientific attitude is that most optometrists and ophthalmologists recommend taking other steps before trying out blue light glasses. The most obvious recommendation is to simply use digital screens less, especially before sleeping. Less screen time means less strain on your eyes. This also extends to taking short breaks between long periods of screen usage, turning on the nighttime mode on your device to decrease its brightness, and even using eye drops to keep your eye moist. In short, scientists aren't saying that blue light does not affect your sleep. It probably does, but its extent isn't necessarily clear yet. What is known is that the persistent screen usage does impact your sleep, and the quickest way to improve your sleep is to minimize that screen usage. More studies need to be conducted so that we can understand the extent of blue light's impact, but right now, if you're struggling with digital screens affecting your sleep, take those tangible steps I mentioned, at least before you dish out some money for blue light glasses. That being said, if you want to give those glasses a try, go for it. Plenty of people speak highly of them, so there should be some benefit to them, even if it's just placebo. Just be aware that the scientific body of research hasn't totally caught up to the glasses yet. As I've said in other videos, if it works for you, keep doing it, and if it doesn't, try something else. Either way, it'll be pretty easy to help your eyes feel just a little bit better.